a country that has geographically more or less the same dimension of Serbia. Demographically, we have more or less also the same population. And economically speaking, we are not that far away. I mean, there are also many other very good examples in this field for Serbia. But if you try to transpose examples from countries that are much bigger in terms of population, geography, and also much different in terms of economic development, probably you will not have exactly the same result. So that is the reason why I keep insisting that the Portuguese success story of organizing the Football European Championship 6 years ago in 2004 is a very good example that really deserves to be studied with great care and with great attention by the Serbian authorities and by the Serbian sports-related associations and responsible people. Let me start with basic assumptions, because you saw, even during the previous presentation, very, very good one and extremely interesting, that now the fully integrated stadium concept is very much widespread. And it is known, it is a tested configuration, and there are a lot of companies worldwide, a lot of European and other nations that are capable of providing this concept. What is really the basic political assumption is that you need, behind this kind of endeavor, a very strong political will and political backing. Now, I am not obviously here trying to interfere in what could be the endeavors or the objectives of Serbian politics or politicians, but we needed back when we started the road to organize the European Championship in 2004 a very strong political will, a very strong and clear concept that meant that organizing a European Championship would be very important for Portugal in terms of international visibility, in terms of promotion of the image of a country. And there are some concepts that here in the Balkans are almost unbeatable from a political standpoint. If you imagine a European football championship co-organized, let's say, by Serbia and Croatia, or by Serbia, Croatia, and Bosnia, not to mention other nations of the Balkans, that is, politically speaking, a concept that would be very difficult to be beaten by any other competitor bid. Why? For obvious political reasons. And UEFA and FIFA, they attach also a very great importance to the political dimension. Imagine a European Championship organized in the Balkans. That would also mean reconciliation. That would also mean a step forward in terms of regional integration. In my view, in my modest view, as a contribution to the thinking about these problems, that would be a very difficult bid to beat. Of course, there are other ways and means to gather political support, not necessarily to organize a European Championship, but the imagination of the responsible people, of the clubs, of the associations involved, of the governments, could find ways of bringing together that political will. Then there is obviously a very important problem, that is the financial one. And the financial engineering that is involved in these fully integrated stadiums, we solved it in Portugal. We solved it in a very successful way and in a very economically and long-term sustainable way. Of course, that needs also a lot of joint efforts from government, from municipalities, from clubs, from private investors. And there is, of course, the need for adapting legislation to promote and to permit those things to happen. Basically, here are most for sure experts that know much more about these things than I do, but I can tell you that basically, in a very rough way, the concept that was used in all the 10 stadiums in Portugal was essentially the following. The stadiums themselves, the field and the places where people sit to watch the games, they either belong to the clubs or to the municipalities. And they were kept that way. They are still that way. They are maintained and they are explored in terms of economical and financial dimensions by the owners that are the clubs and or the municipalities. And then all the infrastructures that are associated to the stadium that create this fantastic view of the fully integrated stadium dimension, they are private owned and private explored, meaning that the shopping mall, the apartment buildings, the parking lot, the office buildings, the hotels, the cinemas, even in the case of Portugal, in two stadiums, hospitals were created, and they are fully developed, maintained, and as I say, financially explored by the private companies. And the private companies gathered the financial necessary investments, the banking loans necessary to build the stadiums. And at the end of the day, the municipalities and the clubs, they did not spend 1 cent in the construction or the renovation of the stadiums. What they lost was, of course, land that belonged to them, and the central government needed to adapt legislation to force in the parliament, sometimes with great difficulty, legislation to pass and to be approved that would allow this kind of public-private partnership to be built. But this is a tested concept. So if here in Serbia or in the Balkans, in the perspective of a joint cross-border multinational endeavor, this experience could be replicated, there are other experiences that were very successful and they could be used as examples for Serbia. And experiences within the European Union with legislation that was adapted according to the European Union acquis and to the European Union rules. So this is not an impossible task, but of course it needs a lot of goodwill and needs a lot of joint efforts. Media awareness and the conversation that we are having here today with this very good initiative is of course a small step on in that way. But we should not lose time. You know that the stadiums in Serbia, even those stadiums from very prestigious football clubs like Partizan, like Red Star, they are in a very poor shape. You also know that responsible people from UEFA already wrote letters to these clubs putting them on notice that if the renovation or the renewable or the building of new stadiums would not take place or will not take place in a foreseeable future, international matches will not be allowed to take place in those stadiums. And clubs as prestigious, with a prestigious history as Partizan or Red Star or Vojvodina, would be in a position to suffer the humiliation of having to play abroad, in Croatia, for instance, or elsewhere, to host or to have the possibility to host international matches, international football matches. And I am sure that the Serbian public, the Serbian fans, the Serbian media would not probably be happy with this kind of prospect. That is not a far, far away prospect. I am not entitled to speak about deadlines, but the representatives of the clubs know better than I do what I am talking about. So this is an urgent thing, a thing that can be done with private money, with banking money funding. So there is no excuse for impediments related to the economic financial crisis, because these are very sound investments that are extremely profitable for the investors. And if the investors don't come and build stadiums in Serbia or in the Balkans, they will find other places where to build them, of course, because, as I say, this concept, this combination of the full integrated stadiums with the shopping mall, apartment, hotel, and other very profitable dimensions is a tested example. A final word from my side to tell you that I know that there are companies, that there are consortia in the making that have been expressing their interests in looking at the Serbian stadium situation from Portugal and from other countries. So there is an interest that is there, and that interest should be really be taken into account and promoted. And of course, at the end of the day, again, everything will boil down to the need not to accommodate dubious interests. That is also a very important dimension, because, as you know, there will always be people that will imagine these very important political dimensions as a way to profit themselves with some attitudes that are not in conformity with such a grand scale and national endeavor as this kind of endeavor should be. A final word, I was about to forget an important dimension. It is related also with changing of the mentality and curtailing violence. You know that this is a problem here in Serbia. It is a problem in many other countries. It was a problem in Portugal. Everything changed with the new stadiums. The only thing that did not change was the enthusiasm, the passion, the soul for the game. That is intact. But the violence changed completely. Why? Not only because of these electronic vigilance media means, because they are also important in that regard, because the new stadium, they really provide a much more secure environment, but also because people are not going to destroy something that is beautiful, brand new. They are enjoying that with their families. I always give the example of my own mother, 83-year-old lady, retired doctor, goes to the Dragão Stadium of FC Porto to buy books and to have coffee, because it is very close to her home. It was something totally impossible some years ago in Portugal, and it is something obviously impossible to do here in Serbia today. So I hope that in the very near future, things start rolling, and that one day, either with Portuguese companies or companies of other European Union or countries from outside the European Union, also with companies from Serbia, because this creates employment, this creates revenues, this brings attention, this attracts tourism, we will be able to celebrate the first brand new stadium in Serbia. Thank you very much.